bench for you, God knows the better way to do it.
Praise God. Amen. Amen. You can't avenge yourself. You can't defend yourself. Amen.
Amen.
But there is one that is able to do all things. Praise God.
Amen.
And that is Jesus. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
And we also know from Romans chapter number 12 from 19, we read it before.
Mm-hmm.
Romans 12, 19.
Dearly beloved, avenge not yourself, but rather give place unto wrath. For it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, says the Lord.
Praise God.
Mm-hmm.
What did God say? He said what? Vengeance is for him. Must you ask him why?
No. God don't have to explain to you why he says
leave vengeance for him. Because he's in position, he knows how to do it. He sees what you cannot see.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So when we rely, that's why Jesus said, he said, cast all your cares upon him. Because he cares for you. Did he say cast 50% of your care? He said what?
Oh!
Praise God. And he knows that there is no one of that care that you can do perfectly. You can't do anyone. Praise God. But when you cast it upon Jesus and you see yourself moving on, praise God. Amen. The grace that he has generated through the blood of Jesus is sufficient for us. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. You can be doing something in your life, if you check it, what you have done in your life that God just granted you, amen, you have success. And you may think that maybe you know how to do it. No. The same way you tried that thing that you are successful, people have tried it 50 times and they failed. Praise God. What makes it different is the grace that was released upon you. Amen.
Amen.
Don't think that you know how to do it. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Now, if you are in your place of work, you have not had any absence one day. Don't think that you are a better worker more than people that are having absence. Praise God.
Amen.
Do you know why? Because you have the grace of health to be able to go to work. There are people who want to go to work, but they are in the hospital for the past 6 months. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
That is grace. Amen? Amen? And what is grace?
Unmerited favor.
Did you merit it?
Mm-hmm.
Nobody merited any favor from God. So we were doomed for destruction. But God is giving to us what our heart desire. What you need, things that will make you to feel okay. But God is not giving to us what we desire. When somebody commits offense in the court, they say, so person deserves 5 years imprisonment. So what we desire is what?
Condemnation.
Is Jesus giving it to us? He's giving us our heart. Desire, and God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
For instance, in Romans chapter number 12, verse 19, believers are not expected to pay back reciprocally. Amen. For any evil done against them, you are not expected to reciprocate any injury or whatever that is done against you. Praise God.
Amen.
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 But you can reciprocate something. And what is that?
Love.
That is all you have to do.
Amen.
Amen. Love.
Conditional.
When people love you, love them back. If they don't love you, love.
Love the unlovable.
Amen.
Mm. But if they don't want you to love them,
just love.
Praise God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Now, praise God. Now, our daddy said, if they don't want you to love them, and the Bible says, if it is possible, be at peace with all men. Nobody have the right to tell you, don't love me. Amen. Amen. Loving them is within you. And nobody have power in you. Am I right? I my love, if you say don't love me, that is your man. In my heart, I love you. In my mind, I love you. Simple. Praise God. Simple. Can you control my mind? You can't control my mind. Praise God. Amen. That is, no one can stop you. Don't love me. Amen. You just love them. That is your responsibility. Amen. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And Jesus will take control.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. All right. Say, admonish us not to stoop low to the level of the offender. And what does that mean?
Doing the same thing that the person doing to you.
Praise God.
Yeah.
Amen.
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 In other words, when a father in the Lord and a son in the Lord are fighting over ministry, they are in the same level. Do we get it now? And he said, do know what? Stoop low. Amen?
Amen.
If you have anything against them, you release the curse from the altar because you are angry. You are at the same level with that son. You are not mature. Amen.
Amen.
But if you are mature enough, you should know that that work is not for you. You are just a laborer. You are not the owner of the work. Amen.
Amen.
You know, they have come to a situation when pastors are hitting their chest. The church I built for many years. Who told you that you built the church? Is it because you are alive that you said that the church you built? What if you sleep, you never wake up? Will you build another church?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So we are messing it up. I have worked in that church for many years, and some pastor will refuse to be transferred. It happened. You can't transfer me. Church I have built. Yeah, I have built for many years. You want to move me to a place? Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. You can see the new generational church. How this confinement in one church is bringing problem. Our apostles, they were having church on the sea, on the field, on the streets. Amen. They were moving around. There were no particular mega church. And there was no problem. Everybody was walking on the street. The altar were in everywhere. Now they confine the altar to a mega church now. That is where the problem is coming on. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So if everybody are in the field, that our brother is always on the field. Amen. So you will know the difference whether it's redeemed or... Because we are in the hall. Church this day is the hall church. Amen.
Amen.
And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 All right. Also teaches us not to take matters into our own hands. And insist on feasting them ourselves. Rather, we should leave things in God's capable hands, knowing that danger is His alone. It's God that can do it well. If God that can do it well. Are you in any situation? Praise God. I know people can come to the church and be smiling, but what they are in, if you see picture of their situation, you know that they are in form of them and in hell. Praise God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And what do we need, how do we pass this message across? Mm-hmm. We must be able to encourage them. Praise God. With the word of God.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, like what you said there, I agree with that 100%. And I think that's really I think that's what we need to drill down on. You know, the passive aggressive retaliation. In the church, it's not always where you see people coming to blows, because we know that we're expected to behave in a certain way.
Yeah.
So somebody can offend another person, and that person, like you said, they will smile.
Yeah.
But then what from that point, the way they begin to relate to you and act towards you and respond to you, they withdraw. They don't receive you anymore. And the most, I believe that the most two things that happen in the church, right, when it, in matters of retaliation, you have boycott, you know. We boycott each other a lot because of things that's been said or done in the past.
Yeah.
It's so easy for me to say, okay, let me use Sister Emmanuel's example. Like, okay, she said something to that I didn't particularly like or take to. So for that reason, whenever she calls, let's say for children's ministry, or whenever she has an opportunity to minister, I withdraw myself, I withdraw my kids, everything from her. It's not violent. It's not confrontational. It's not all up in your face, but it's passive aggressive revenge. It's retaliation, but on the sly. So we come in here. We greet each other. We smile. You know, shalom, shalom. We do all of that, but deep down, you know, the way that what we think about each other, how we feel about each other, is still anchored on certain events that's happened in the past where I was offended. I was offended because you corrected me. I was offended because you say this. I was offended because you say that. So even though I'm not coming to confront you, even though I'm not coming to be all up in your face, even though we're not coming to blows, the way that we begin to relate to each other, that in itself is retaliation. But it's just passive, aggressive retaliation.
Amen.
So that's something that we need to really drill down as a church and make sure that when we say we forgive, we really forgive and let go and move on.
That is cold war.
Praise God. Amen. That is a wonderful one.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
We must be able to control our mind.
Mm.
I said that mind is very powerful.
Yeah.
No one can walk in your mind.
Mm.
But you can renew your mind yourself.
Mm.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. In first situation, when you forgive somebody, and everybody must be prepared to learn. Amen.
Amen.
And must be prepared to rate the other higher than you. That's what the Bible said. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. You must look at the other in a very high esteem. Praise God.
Amen.
Let me start from, you understand what I mean? So when you look at others in a very high esteem, other people look at you in a very high esteem. Because that is the golden rule. It moves around. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
And in a situation where you cannot relate with people because you don't know if you relate with them, it will bring misunderstanding. Praise God. It can come from that situation.
Absolutely.
When you, okay, maybe if you relate with the womb, you maybe your statement will be misunderstood.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
And you can see people just, okay, let me just forget.
Can I give an example?
Yeah.
Okay. There was a time when Peter would eat with the Gentiles.
Yeah.
He would sit down and eat with the Gentiles.
Yeah.
But when Satan came from Jerusalem, he withdrew himself, fearing those which are of the circumcision.
Yeah.
And Paul confronted him in front of everybody regarding that. You know? He confronted him and they made their peace, but he confronted him in front of everybody. Now, when you read what Peter says about Paul later on, you know there was no grudge.
No.
Peter was senior to Paul.
Yeah.
He could have said, listen, I've been in this place longer than you have been. I've been in the ministry, I walked to Jesus, you didn't.
Yeah.
You know, he could have pulled rank on him, but he didn't. He just took the correction humbly, quietly, and adjusted and moved on.
Yeah.
Later on, when Peter is writing, you actually hear Peter commending Paul on the revelation that God has given him. Peter himself said, you know what? Some of the things that Paul says, it's not easy for everyone to understand. That shows you that he didn't hold any grudges at all. That shows you that he didn't look to boycott Paul's ministry. Because Peter could have said some things that would have been damaging to Paul's ministry if he really wanted to. But he didn't.
Praise God.
He just took it and moved forward with
Amen.
It.
Amen. That is maturity. Praise God.
Amen.
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 That is maturity in the word of God.
Amen.
Ability to understand. Praise God. And the Bible says, if it is possible, be at peace with all men.
Amen.
If it is possible. Praise God. In some situation, it might not be possible to be at peace with them.
Mm.
But you can be at peace from your mind.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. But they don't have the power to control your mind. You can be at peace with them through your mind.
Mm.
But be at peace with them, it can be sometimes may be very difficult.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. So we must be able to control our mind. When you forgive, make sure you forgive. And everyone should be prepared to learn. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
For example, we are talking about love here. For example, maybe we are sitting together, like every Sunday like this. Maybe I sit with Sister Zeni talking. I notice that she don't want me like to come closer to her. I'm just making an example. Yeah? Maybe I noticed that not once, not twice. You understand? You know we have to use wisdom. That didn't measure about maybe if that person don't want to love me. It's your mind. Yeah? If you want to love, you love. You don't have to say it out. Maybe as I notice it, one, two, three. Next time, maybe I can sit in the back, because I have noticed, not that I don't love her, but I have to use my wisdom.
But if you ask,
you understand,
if you probably you say, I noticed this, or you see me, or
maybe if I ask, you say, no, no, I'm not like that. Why? She will just laugh. But
then
example,
you have push it to her,
even
if she have that thought, if she have that thing that is withdrawing her, she know that you notice, and you push it to her, so it's left to her now to go and change.
I know, but I will not.
But if you are that's what Ramayan is pointing out. We fight cold war in the church.
That's what I'm saying. I don't have to hold her in my mind. But I have to use my own wisdom. Because I know what she don't like. You understand?
You don't know what she doesn't like.
I know because I've noticed it not once, not twice.
Wait, sister. Sorry. You know sometimes we approach the floating symptom of matter. We did not realize the source of the problem. We are human beings and we are individual. Sometimes maybe I'm going through on my personal way in my marriage or in my home or something, which you don't know. But my body language is speaking something different. What you get is what you see me maybe doing. But you are not actually the problem. Do you understand what I'm saying? You are not the issue at all. I'm not even thinking about you at that particular time. I don't even know if my body language speaks something else to you. But it's just me, my internal me, what something is going. That's why if you are bold enough to say, sister, the way you react, probably I will go back to say, even though it affects you, and I didn't know it affects you, but it's not you, or something. Sometimes we need to come clear. Instead of try to avoid the situation, let's try and wash it out.
It's just to go ahead. Love do not judge. So you don't assume, like because the sister don't like you, don't want your cooking. Just give her credit, like mommy said.
Somebody to sit with again, we run.
Okay, praise God.
Well, anyway,
because of time.
I just wanted to say quickly, right, you know, whenever there's that kind of conflict, you see what Jesus said is that if there's an issue between you and a brother, you go to the brother and you iron it out between the two of you.
Or you tell the elder.
If they can't hear you, you go and pull a witness first. And then it's like between the three of you. You try to iron it out. Amen. And if that doesn't work, then you go before the church. And then that brother will be like a heathen to you. That's what Jesus said. So sometimes it's you don't have to go and confront, like, okay, I notice that whenever I sit next to you, you start developing a rash on your side. You don't want anything to do. You know, you don't have to go and do that.
Okay.
But you can have a conversation.
Okay. All right. Praise God.
A lovely conversation.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. The wonderful contribution. Praise God. Amen. In everything, we must apply wisdom.
Exactly.
Praise God. Amen. There's people that you can't have conversation of body odor with. It will bring war.
It depends on the way you
praise
say
God.
It.
Amen.
Sister, you have body odor.
Yeah, okay. All right.
I will run away.
Amen. No, whatever way you want to put it, you must have, you must be very careful. There are situations that you have to use prayer to just address the issue. Praise God. Amen. That is my own way. You use prayer to, okay, because of time now. What I want to say, you can't change people's mind. The word of God has the power to change people's mind. I'll take it from what our mommy just said. You can look at somebody that is cutting you or one thing or the other. Maybe without checking the situation, maybe the person is tense up in a very difficult situation that he can't voice out. Praise God. And that situation is dwelling on him. Praise God. Amen. And then you can look at it maybe with, okay, maybe he's persecuting me or he's doing this. It's not in your matter. Praise God. So in his whole situation, he's just confronting issues. Praise God. That's why we always have to look at things in different ways. In different ways and in different understanding. If I bring a number of C's, I bring it to you. When you look at it in your way, it becomes C's. If I look at it from my way, it's 9. Depends on the angle I stand to look at it. Both of us are right, if you look at it. Amen. But we must have to apply wisdom in addressing issues. You can look at somebody, maybe is running for, she's running from you. She's not even running from you. She's not in your matter.
Know what is going on.
She don't even know. Praise God. We should be able to control our imagination. Maybe it's that one that is happening. Forget about it. You focus on your own cross.
Yeah.
Amen. Focus on your own self, your own relationship. Amen.
So that, you know, by telling somebody, his sister, like, sister is moving away from his sister, you can as well help that person.
Yeah.
You know that people are going through a life that they neglect themselves.
Yeah.
Probably the person is smelling, having money. That's why the person is moving out. If you say it out, maybe the pastor or somebody might be able to call the person. And the other sister will say, this is what I've noticed. And they will tackle the, you might help that person. You might help the person is passing through it, neglecting himself, not cleaning, not brushing, not doing anything.
It can even be a disease.
It can be a disease. So we are helping. Like we shouldn't keep quiet in the house. You know, we shouldn't keep quiet.
No, keeping quiet. When we say love, and love the unconditional.
Yeah.
For example, if somebody, I'm working with somebody that I know he doesn't really want to. You know, some people don't want to work with you, no matter what you do.
Yeah.
When we are talking about love, we have two. We have job for two people. I got there first. I did 3/4 of the work. For example, I'm trying to love without even saying a word. And I'm showing example in practical. When the person come and meet me, oh, you've gone so far. I say, yes, this is what's remaining. Can you join hand? Let's do it. You understand? When he's coming next, we say, I don't know what I can say again. I love working with this person because she always do the work, even beyond. You don't need to say something. Sometimes you just need to look for something to penetrate, there will always be a window, an exit for us to penetrate, especially where you are, when, if you are somebody that go on your knee and pray. And whenever you are praying, you remember the person. I can't love her on my own. Help me to be able to show it and prove that I'm Christ-like.
Well, quickly, I will take another question after this. Amen. The second outline said, the proper Christian approach. Amen. Matthew chapter number 5:38 to 44, read it before. It says, serve to drive home the point that a Christian, rather than avenging themselves against anyone who have hurt them, personally should rather love their enemy, bless those that curse them, do good to those that hate them, and pray for those who despitefully use and persecute them. Avenging ourselves has no place in the Christian life. We should allow God to bring his vengeance on our enemy rather than seeking to avenge ourselves. Praise God. As a believer, we must resist the impulse to retaliate negatively. Amen. As our brother just said, amen. You might not do it in a direct way, but you are doing it in a corny way. Praise God. You can retaliate by your way of doing. Amen. You can retaliate by ignoring the person. Praise God. You can retaliate by your attitude. Amen. Whether you do it by attitude or you do it in another form, do not avenge yourself. Praise God. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Some people need to receive slap.
Slap.
Praise God. Amen.
Turn the other cheek.
That's what the Bible says.
Praise God. Amen.
Some pastor get to the altar to retaliate. He won't say it direct. Some minister will even climb the altar to reply what he wanted, you know.
I retaliate through message.
Something like that.
Yeah, back it up with the word of God. Back it up with the word of God.
Yeah, but yeah, the word of God is always there for you.
Talking to the person directly, you know, when they take microphone. Yeah, when they take microphone, the first thing you have them say is, when some people are doing, they will start moving around the corner.
Praise God. Amen. God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. All right. So we can trust that our defender will do what is right, I said before. We can always set a healthy boundary in destructive or harmful relationship and make our ways pleasing unto God. Praise God. Amen. Quickly, let's read Psalm 20, verse 1. Psalm 20, verse 1, 2 Corinthians, chapter number 6, verse 17, and somebody open to Proverbs, chapter number 16, verse 7, quickly. If you are there, let me know.
Psalm 20, verse 1, it said, may the Lord answer you when you are in trouble. May the God of Jacob protect you. May he send you help from his temple and give you aid from Mount Zion.
Praise God. Who has the power to do all this?
God.
And he has the power to protect you from your enemy.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. If God worrying about your enemy, praise God.
Amen.
And what did David say? Your enemy, whether you kill, that is why God said, pray, that is what Jesus said, pray for your enemy. Because they can't stop you from progressing if God is by your side.
Okay.
And then he said, God what? He prepared a table before me, even in the presence of my enemy. That is, his enemy is not the problem.
Well, how come some churches or some ministry, they now enemy die or enemy that and enemy this? Is that, are they not, is this is the Bible not, is the Bible not, I don't know how to say
this, an understanding depends. Now I can say I'm not in position to say that what they are doing is wrong. I have to be very careful when you are talking.
Yeah, maybe, I know.
Amen.
Saying, yeah.
Maybe if I read the Word of God, I have a different understanding. If Brother Moya read the same place, you have a different vision. Praise God. Amen. If you read the same chapter, you have a different vision and a different way of interpreting it to people. Praise God.